At last, here it is, Rare's remake of the truly, truly special Conker's Bad Fur Day, which I'm sure you're all very aware was released in the N64. Conker's first release was a tragic tale. It was something new, exciting and fresh. Unfortunately, the Nintendo 64 at the time wasn't. It was kinda like a funeral, a big busty tart stripper bursting out of a coffin like it was a birthday cake, so Nintendo did the only thing that could have been expected to do. They made every effort to cram said stripper back into the coffin and bury it with all deceased. Well, half a decade's passed since, and now Rare have made the move to recoup some of the vast sums of cash they rightly should have made from the original. Just a glance at Live and Reloaded is enough to tell you where the majority of the programmer's time was spent. It's lovely looking. That old raunchy rough around the edges tart that was buried with the N64 has been replaced by a refined and well-poised beauty. Even in this generation of consoles, you have to pay the price for sparkly graphics, just like your new stunning girlfriend who spent 2 hours in the bog every morning getting ready. Of the 8 or 10 hours or so a single player in Live and Reloaded, you'll be staring at about 2 hours of fucking loading screens. Maybe 2 hours is a bit of exaggeration, but they are very, very noticeable. Single player mode in this, however, isn't the hook for a number of us, or at least it wasn't for me. I wasn't expecting many big surprises from one player, so most of my attention was spent in the live aspect. And this, I'm afraid, is where my review starts to go a bit downhill, because like most who look forward to Conker Online, always had it in my mind that when it came out, it would be a Conker game, which you'd play online with other players. But it ain't so though, Joe. Because we threatened Microsoft enough, we managed to get a preview copy, and for the first week or so on live, it was a bit quiet, but I have been on a handful of times since general release. And the reason for my lack of enthusiasm for the live option is something that our American cousins are all too happy to point out. It's frequently been compared to Halo Online, which hurts my gaming heart a bit. It just wasn't what I was expecting. The live option gives you level-specific goals and straightforward deathmatches and a selection of classes, some of which are initially incredibly unbalanced. Don't get me wrong, on live Conker is a chaotic and frantic and quite exciting few hours of play, but I guess I just had a little too much faith in Rare. I was looking forward to a bit more innovation, really, rather than another shooter aimed at mainly American teens. All of the online levels are very well designed and well presented, and it plays well if a little floaty, but there's nothing unique about it. Online, it's just a Microsoft game. Everything's there in front of you and it looks good, but at the same time, nothing's there. So the live mode isn't for me, but I'm a snobby bastard, so you don't have to listen to me. So it's back to one player with me. Lovely, beautiful one player. As you're moving through the main game, if you've played the original, you'll quickly notice you remember just about every inch of it, which is a testament to how great the original was. The graphics aren't the only improvement either. The camera's got better, but we'll still have you screaming in certain close situations. Your squirrel control's better too, unless you're in the back of a dinosaur. But the game carries over some things I think could have been smoothed out. There's some right bastard leaps of faith, and sometimes there's areas you can clearly get into, but you're bounced off invisibility shields, something that nowadays looks really awful. There's no completely new areas in one player, a couple of redesigned bits, like the Van Helsing style section. The game hasn't been busied up any, it's just strictly linear as it was originally. If you mill around, you'll get bored, guaranteed. But if you do what you're supposed to do, it's still really enjoyable. The characters I remember funny are still. As a platformer, it's no Mario 64, and it's no Epic unless the live option gets its hooks into you, but as a good day's entertainment, it's still gold. If you've not played the original, it's a must buy. And if you have played the original and you're not adverse to online shooters, then you should buy it as well. As for me, I think I'll just go on holding my big busty tart stripper version in slightly higher esteem.